What's up, gamers? Today we have a extremely close battle. I'm not gonna say who wins or who loses, but it comes down to me with 10 HP against the Scorpion G.
If everyone was playing, what would they recommend? Would they recommend going with the Object 277 or would they go with the IS-7? Which one's your favorite? Let me know in the comments down below.
But it's a 5.8k damage game, I think. 5.8? Around 5.8. 5.5, something like that, add 1.8k of assistance, so roughly 7k.
We are closing in on that 500 subscriber mark. We are currently at 419, so if everyone can hit that subscribe button and help me get to the 500, that is most appreciated.
I don't even know what this map's called these days. What is this one called? Serene Coast. It's under Canada on the replays. But, yes, we're going to go after the Leopard. We're going to go off to the sort of H9, H8. What we can get there, but we do stick one into the Leopard. It is only me and a Chrysler. There is a Conqueror coming. Let me see the CS-59. Unfortunately, the Leopard is in the middle and the STB-1 has gone to the other side. So the tier 10s aren't there and our tier 10s have gone the other way as well. So I'm not too worried about the tier 10s. But the T10 is great. It has the better gun of the 257. It has 258mm of AP armor for 440 and the typical 340 heat, which 10mm more than most people's. Now, its armor is okay. It works, but it can let you down. It's obviously very pipe nose, so there's no tire scraping or anything like that. And the turret has a bit of a weak point. And can be overmatched. I do know it can be overmatched. Can't remember why, what from, but I do know it can be. Now, we're fighting a Tiger II, and unfortunately we took a heat shell. Nope, the heat shell bounced from the IS-3A. We take that one from the Tiger, which probably went into the side. Now you can actually see, it's a fairly accurate tank, considering it's a Russian 120, I think it's a 122, isn't it not? Is it 122 shells? Yeah, 122. But yeah, as you can see, we'll take out the Tiger too because he is going to cause some issues for either me or the Chrysler. There's a Conqueror and a T-54E1. Now, I haven't been paying attention as to how many the 54E1 has fired, but we're going to go and take him out because he is the more dangerous tank. And from here, I know that the other guys can't push around, especially with the SU-130. And if you can see him down here in the map, in the corner, providing cover from these guys pushing over. Now, the Conqueror is going to be the next dangerous target. And fortunately, he does get one into us. Which probably just goes... I'm not actually sure where he fired there. That one's into the lower plate by the Conqueror. But we're going to stick another one straight into him. In his track and lock him down for our Conqueror to deal some damage. Staying with the CS-59, we have these automatic fire extinguisher gone, and we're already up to 3,500 damage, 1,400 assistance. Most of them are from obviously tracking. Someone else obviously set him on fire when his extinguishers went, and the IS-3A with his auto loader did manage to put another one into us with its heat for 342. Now we're only at 500 damage, so. Scorpion G, I am a 50-50 chance on whether it can hit me, pretty much. And obviously the Skoda T-56 is more than capable of double-tapping me. Now we see the tree fall there, which is obviously a telltale sign that there is actually somebody there. The S1, obviously he will make mincemeat of our armor. His penetration is like 280-something, 288 or something. Something ridiculous. It will just go straight through us. But nonetheless, we are going to push on, see if we can get one shot into him. Now, the weakness of this tank is the gun depression. They're still good on the turret. And he pulls up, and we take the chance. 385 straight into him. Now, this M3Y proves a bit of a difficultness to us. Fortunately, that doesn't go through. I saw that the turret was a flat turret. And a bit sad really that it didn't go in. We could have done with that extra shot. Obviously the Conqueror is still full HP. Not even full HP, half HP. but considering it's a Conqueror, it's about the same as the M3Y, what's left. And I tried to inform him that there is a tank out the back, which is obviously going to be the Scorpion. So we can't really push around. And we try and go for the Compola, but it's not an easy shot, especially from down below, and he's using his gun depression. Now, I see the light tank, and I'm wondering if I can actually squeeze a shot in by looking at this mini-map. I feel like I can. And I saw a peek of him there. Just checking off behind me, just to make sure that that M3Y is not going to push. And we see him, we aim. Wait for the right time, and we take out the LT-432, which is probably almost could be game-winning, because he could disappear. We'll go and circle the SU-130. Currently, it's 2.4 versus 3.8, which is 2,100 down in HP. The M3Y pushes. I managed to get a massive 478 shell into him. Remember, this gun is 440. It's not the 390, it is the 440. Now, thankfully, this Chrysler is getting help with the T56 Skoda. Now, I'm just trying to decide here. Do I go and help them, or can I stick a shot in again from the side? But it doesn't look like we can, so I'm going to push into the middle. And we come straight across the score with BNG, 400 damage. Now, I'm going to have to push around. I'm having a look, see what I can do, see where we can push to. I see the Scorpion, and that was the Conqueror behind me dying, so I know that the M3Y is pushing me, so I don't want to make it a Peninsula mover, so I move up into this rock and try and get hold down, because it does have a pretty good turret. So we turn, we get ready for the M3Y. That was that gun depression. Snap one straight into, I would imagine, his lower plate / flywheel for his track. And it is now a 1v2, a 1v1. It is me and the Scorpion. He obviously is a two shot, but we managed to slam one into him there. We are both now one shots for each other. I am at 5.5k damage and 4 kills, and I don't know what he is at, but it is 1.8k of assistance for us as well. And I just think, right, we need to push him, and I even think I can either get him across there. Nope. So I'm just going to push at him. Sometimes this is the best, catch him off guard, which it does. He doesn't have a fast turret. And we snap the last one into him on the move. For 5.884, it was 5.8k damage and 1.8k of assistance. Now let's jump into those post-game stats and see how we did. Okay, so these are the post-game stats. We ended up with the Mastery Badge, 135,000 credits and 4.8k of XP. We had 5 kills, 5,800 damage, and 1,800 assistance. Me and the Chrysler and the Conqueror pushed heavy on that side and basically won it. We ended up with 6. He got 3, and he also got 3. Fired 20 shots, hit 19, and penned 16. Obviously, some of them were bounces off the turret of the M3Y and the Tiger II. We only blocked 1,400, which, yeah, it isn't the worst. It's doable, but the Skoda 4.6, the STB 3.9. That Scorpion did actually do 3,000 damage, which is actually, you know, that was alright for him. The T-54, he only managed to pen one of his shots. The Tiger II we took right out of the game, and the IS-3 only penned me just before he died. We made 84,000 credits on that, and we had a 1,600 base experience, which was 1,608. So an extremely good game with 5 kills. Obviously, me and the Chrysler had 9 kills between us, so we pretty much taken out the entire enemy team minus a few. So that is a nice quick one on a clutch win in Russian Tier 9 T10. Now, if you had to ask me the Object 277 grind or the IS-7 grind, I like the T10 over the 257 probably 2 or 3 times over. The T10, I loved playing it. Amazing gun, amazing mobility. Yes, the armor isn't as good as the 257, but it's also not as trolly. And I find myself trying to use the 257 armor because that's its strong point and its gun is a bit weak. The T10, amazing. But That's just my opinion. If you don't agree, just jump down to the comments and let me know. And if you don't have anything to say, just leave an emoji because engagement. And don't forget to subscribe.